The US Supreme Court is set to overturn Roe v. Wade, the historic judgment protecting access to abortion for American women. But in a country already divided by hyper-partisan politics, there's concern the decision could lead to widespread unrest. Andrea Grimes is a Texas-based journalist who covers reproductive rights. Kia ora, Andrea. Thanks for being with us on Q&A. What was your reaction when you saw that draft decision?
Yep, thanks so much for having me. My reaction to the Supreme Court draft was devastation, but not surprise. I've been covering abortion rights and news in Texas and the United States for 12 years. This is a path that the American right wing has been taking us down for decades. They've been very open about their plan to overturn Roe versus Wade, to ban abortions by any means necessary. We've known it's coming for a long time, but that doesn't make the reality any less terrifying, and the impact any less dismaying. We know this is going to disproportionately impact folks of color in the United States, low-income people, and it's just really it's bizarre to think about something becoming reality that folks have been scared of and preparing for years and years and years.
You know, it is extraordinary for watchers of the Supreme Court to see an opinion like this leaked to the media. What does it say about this issue in particular that this was leaked?
My goodness. I think it speaks to how... high touch this issue is for us. The Supreme Court covers all sorts of controversial issues, obviously, that is the nature of the work that they do, right? To have this leak, and you know, there's been a lot of speculation. Was it someone from the right or the left? You know, I'm not sure that the actual nature of the origin is particularly important, but I think it shows the passion that people have to be right on this, to get it settled right either way. And it's very bizarre. It was very unexpected. It's not unprecedented, but it is unusual. And it does speak to how anxious the American people are, I think, to figure out what's going on at the Supreme Court. It's such a politicized court now. Again, very bizarre, not unprecedented, but really shocking.
What's going to happen if this opinion is confirmed?
If the opinion is confirmed, then there are 26 states in the U.S. that are certain or likely to ban abortion care as soon as possible. So those states are predominantly located in the South and the Midwest and then Texas, and then sort of the upper West, Middle West. Mm. So abortion access will persist in the coasts, in the Northeast, in states like Illinois, perhaps, right? But vast swaths of the U.S. are going to be wholly without clinical abortion providers. Some states will move immediately to ban abortion. They have what's called trigger laws that have been on the books, some for months and some for decades, that have said, you know, abortion will be banned here as soon as Roe versus Wade is overturned. Other states, it might take weeks, it might take months, but they'll move quite quickly.
It's interesting, over the last couple of days I've seen comments from abortion access advocates saying that this decision would put America back 50 years. It would be like 1973 before Roe versus Wade was actually passed. But just to play devil's advocate for a moment, a majority of abortions in 2022 are provided via pill form, aren't they? So isn't there a possibility that women in states where abortion might be banned can still access abortion by getting abortion providers in other states to send them a pill?
It is certainly a possibility. There have been great advances in medicine since 1973. Medication abortion is an incredible innovation. However, we're not talking about going back to the coat hanger days. We fingers really, really, really crossed on that. That's why we're really trying to educate people about medication abortion in the United States. Self-managed medication abortion can be really, really safe. But if people don't have the information they need, on how the pills work, how best to use the pills, when folks shouldn't be using the pills. The pills are not indicated for every pregnancy. They can only be used up to a certain period, right? So I think you see the main concern with abortion by mail, medication abortion by mail, I think also is that we have no reason to believe that states where abortion will be banned will not seek to criminalize the import and use of those pills. We've already seen attacks and attempts at prosecuting folks for self-managed abortion. And, you know, there are something the Biden administration might do. They could attempt to make medication abortion better available by mail. It's banned in a lot of places already. But that's going to be, I don't think there's any reason to expect that a state like Texas is just going to sit there and let folks receive this vital, essential, life-saving medication. It's not part of their MO.
Well, that's right. I mean, Texas has already introduced a bounty hunter style system to try and restrict abortions so far. And I note that lawmakers in Louisiana are proposing that anyone who tries to access an abortion might be charged with murder in the future. I was outside the Supreme Court in 2020 when Amy Coney Barrett was confirmed as a justice just days before the US election. It was a criticism at that moment, and it's a criticism that continues. The US Supreme Court has become incredibly partisan, has become incredibly politicized. What do you think this draft decision says about the politicization of the US Supreme Court?
You know, I think that it says that the long-term project of this politicization has been realized. I don't think there's any reason to think that some of the more conservative justices on the court, Clarence Thomas, for example, weren't put on the court to enact, to back conservative laws, right? But I think that the Trump appointees on the court were put there specifically to overturn Roe versus Wade. I think we saw that this question was on folks' mind during the confirmation hearings for those justices. And those justices really waffled on that. They didn't want to give a straight answer to the question. You know, they relied on precedent, on stare decisis, saying Roe versus Wade is settled law. But advocates knew, we could read between the lines. We knew that those were smoke screens. Again, the right wing in the United States has been very, very clear about its goals to ban abortion by any means necessary. And they have achieved that. And it has really, it's shocking, it's devastating, and it's 100% expected.